We're joined now from the House of Commons by the Tory MP, the man who led in many ways the rebels in the Tory party, David Burrows. David Burrows, well, this is a pretty resounding vote, 400 against 135 in the Mother of Parliaments. That's democracy, isn't it?
It is democracy, and it was resounding in favour of the principle of the bill, but there was a significant, perhaps even unprecedented, in terms of a government bill, for them to, the government not to be able to rely upon half of members of parliament from their own benches, which shows the deep concern that there is in the party and also across parties. I think as we go through the passage of the bill, we'll see increasing numbers from other parties as well, recognising their and voting their opposition, particularly when it goes over to the Lords. I think they've got their beady eye on the fact that there are so many people, so many members of Parliament opposing.
Well, you say increasing numbers from other parties. We've seen about 20 Labour people voted against it. You've got some Ulster Unionists.
I think
you're scraping the barrel a bit, aren't you?
I mean, less Labour. Well, I mean, many have sat on their hands as well. They're waiting for third reading to see if there's any change in the way this bill redefines marriage and the protections for churches and others. If there's no extra amendments and changes, then there'll be many more, I would believe, that we'll be voting against at third reading.
But we now can you tell whether you got many ministers or indeed whips? Did you see any whips in your lobby?
Yeah, there was a bunch of whips, a bunch of senior ministers, cabinet ministers. So this was across all ranks of the party.
Who did you see from the cabinet?
Owen Paterson, David Jones.
Tell me this, there's now a critical vote about the guillotine, which will be whipped. Do you think that ministers and whips are going to defy that?
I think there's a recognition that once we've got over this principal vote, then the business is of balancing the government, getting their business through and ensuring this is scrutinised. So the numbers of votes, I think, would be less, and I don't think there'll be many ministers losing their careers on the basis of the programme.
What would you say to those who were, say, of the 139 of you who voted against this from the Conservative Party, that you're kind of out of step with real and dramatic changes in society in the last 30 years, which have given rights to gay people, to people of colour, to all sorts of people who really do deserve equality under the law?
I mean, it would be more than 139, we're just not quibbling on the figures, but the point is that this debate and this bill is about marriage. It's not about one's views about homosexuality. That's something which quite properly has been settled, and it's important that, sadly, what happens all too often is people who, like myself, who vote against the bill are easily criticised for being homophobic.
Recognise... Let's stick to marriage. Let's look at that. I mean, didn't you find there was something hypocritical about MPs in that chamber where there's a notorious life of people who've had relationships with their secretaries, people who have had many marriages and the rest of it? I mean, what is the sanctity of marriage that is being broken by this? Marriage is a very difficult condition, and it's something which every human has the right to have an attempt at.
Well, at the very least, we should perhaps be spending more time and attention looking at the fragility of marriage up and down this country and doing more to support it. But we're not voting purely on our own view of our own experience of marriage. It's also not just an issue about couples getting into marriage, their access to marriage. It's about the whole social institution, whether you're gay, straight, married or not. We all have an interest in marriage, particularly defined between a man and a woman, the enduring value, relationship to children and all the rest of it, which now we're seeking to redefine and unravel in a historic way.
David Burrows, thank you very, very much for coming out to talk to us.